Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to DC Universe Online. I am, of course, Trex, and alongside me this evening, we have Super Patriot.
What's up, everybody?
And Brittany is either going to be late or she's not going to show up at all because she's on strike.
She needs to show up. She needs to show up because I'm getting tired of this.
I mean, she knew we were going to have a show. She knew.
Yes.
We talked about it today.
We spoke about it earlier. She even wished us to have a good show. Or at least you.
Because she's on strike. And I tweeted it. I just tweeted it maybe like an hour ago. I opened up a booster bundle. And it's my first one. Used my station cash. I got the purple solo aura. So, yeah. So that happened. And she was on, and she decided to go on strike. Because, you know, RN Jesus loves me. I love him.
The thing is, you know, she got some fan on her stream or gave her a bunch of free auras yesterday. Gave her a shit ton of free auras yesterday. And, you know, including, you know, some like solars, you know, and I think a cosmic material. So she didn't have to buy any booster bundles. And she already had these damn things.
No, it's under contract from MEPS and the rest of DCO. She has to buy booster bundles. She has to. They need new coffee machine.
A couple ago, she bought them that conference room.
Yep.
She sponsored that conference room. The last one, I know she bought Spittle's old parking space.
That is right.
What was this year? What was she paying for this year?
I believe a popcorn maker.
A popcorn maker?
I believe so. It's, you know, this year they want to just go, or this time around they want to go a little crazy this time. Because, you know, like every other thing has been business. It's been business, but now they want a little fun money.
I thought maybe that she'd get a goldfish dispenser for Locke.
Yeah, no, he's on a diet. He's doing good. We don't want to jinx it. but yes, tonight we're going to be talking about the booster bundle that came back up yesterday, and along with Game Update 60, Episode 24, and that stuff. So yay! But first, we're going to start things off as usual. Soups, how's your week been?
Shitty. I mean, it was halfway decent
until Thursday.
Yeah, until yesterday, and then you know, people, I swear, are very resistant to common sense.
That seems to be the internet's forte.
And apparently, nobody there. The number of people who can agree to disagree is diminishing worldwide.
Mm. It's true.
Lost a friend yesterday over a disagreement.
I saw that too.
About these booster bundles that we're going to talk about.
Yeah, it's this whole booster bundle thing once again divides the community, and not even in a good way, and it just the nonsense from folks is crazy. It really is with this booster bundle stuff.
I disagree with somebody on one thing. And all of a sudden, you know, I'm completely ignorant of, you know, issues like, you know, one-hander being, you know, exploited with the flip slash range, or issues with PvP, or electricity in nature not, you know, getting any attention for over a year, you know, getting the buff they need. You know, suddenly, like, you know, just because, you know, I don't think the booster bundles are, you know, what they term unethical or a hustle, suddenly now, all of a sudden, like, I've never agreed with them on those other points, and here I am just selling out, and, you know, or I'm a company man, or...
No, that's my
I'm
job.
Always defend, that's I'm me. Always defending the devs. No, dude, I mean, you know, I mean, I got straight called up a company man yesterday. I got straight up told that I'm always, I'm constantly defending the devs. There's even a poll out there right now, which the results should be coming in here shortly, I believe, on what to rename my league to.
Wow, that went really deep.
whether it should be renamed to company men, sellouts, corporate something, or you know, there was a couple other options. I'll have to look it up and find.
Do we have to get like Rooted to approve the name change?
No, Rooted was told yesterday by this individual that her opinion doesn't matter because she's a woman. Hashtag vote Trump.
Oh my God, that is absurd.
Yeah.
So that's something. Anyways, my week has been okay. Wow, that's
So I mean, all that because I didn't disagree because I didn't agree with this guy about the booster bundles and tried to partake some common knowledge on him. Common sense knowledge.
Yeah, on no
him. That, yeah, that you want to say that you're not getting what not getting the monetary value or the worth of out of a booster bundle. Technically, you are. Everything in there adds up to 1,000 marketplace cash. All right. Now, if you want to get technical, all right, you're paying for those items and you're getting a free item out of that booster bundle. And if you continuously try to convince me to say it's not free, all right, yeah, I mean, technically, yeah, you had to buy the booster bundle. Don't get me wrong. But the item that comes with those rare items, those auras and that material that comes with that booster bundle, it is free because they normally charge 300 to 500 marketplace cash for those items.
It's true.
I mean, I can sit here and I will agree with people on, I would like to see some of the consumables replaced with others. Like, I wouldn't mind seeing the R&D scanner and the radar enhancer and maybe even the repair bot go away and see more TRKs, full recovery kits, introduced with it.
I mean, some of us use those enhancers, sir. Okay.
Yeah. Don't get me wrong. I still use them too, but I would rather the booster bundles and all that. I would rather see those TRKs in with the booster bundles. All right. I'd rather purchase those enhancers. Whenever I need them. When new content comes out, I'll use a radar enhancer. I'll take a large chunk of the radar enhancers I have, and I'll give them to an alt that I want to complete all the investigations and briefings on, or I may want to go farm collections on that I need to complete on, because I still like to try and complete all that stuff instead of just, feed unlocking. Sit there and say that it's a flat out scam. It's not. You're getting, you pay $10,000, you're getting $10,000 worth of items out of it.
$1,000.
Thank you.
Yeah, I can't pay $10,000 marketplace cash. That equals out to a monetary value for PC, and I would get so much trouble from my accountant.
Your accountant. You don't have an accountant.
I do. I'm crazy. Woo. my week has been pretty good.
It hasn't. Shut up.
It has. You crazy. I've gotten some sleep, I guess, if that's what you call it. I finished the Black Ember Let's Play series for Fire, my leveling guide, or tutorial, whatever you want to call it. So I edited 7 videos yesterday, and they're all prepped and ready to go throughout for the next now 6 days, because I just released one today. So, yay! that will be done next week. And I found that when I was editing that, I spent maybe 20 to 30 minutes doing the outside leveling stuff. And then once I get into the secret base, I'm there for less than 15 minutes. Why? Because I am spamming the hell out of volatility and fire and flame cascade and fire burst. That's my day. Just not even skipping a beat. Even if an enemy's not there, I'm still just randomly hitting those buttons, just plowing through everything. So if you know your advanced mechanic leveling up, it is such a breeze. Well, besides the points when you get knocked on your butt and you're getting low of health and you're like, oh crap, I gotta freak out real fast. Oh wait, I'm fire. I'm good. Everything dies. But it was also cool to find out that there are 18 story arcs, including the final level 30, your final mission for your mentor. That's including that. So 18 story arcs while you're leveling up. I was really intrigued by that number. Just because I never knew the number. So now it's like new knowledge to me.
Yeah, it's funny because since they changed the leveling up process, the way it all works out and everything with how it hands out missions and stuff,
mm-hmm.
I only have like three or four tunes, I think, that have been leveled up on that process and everything. And I was going through clearing journals out and some of my alts that I've been working on. And I'm looking at some of the missions on there and I'm like, oh, wow, I never did the OMAC mission on this tune. Yeah, the level 27 OMAC mission.
Yeah,
I never did that on his tune. And I was like, which means I never did the Lair of Spectre. And then, oh my gosh, look at that. I never completed the final mentor mission to where you join the Justice League, become an official member of the Justice League. I was like, well, damn. I was like, okay. So I had to knock those out real quick. But I have leveled a few tunes up too recently. My new fire tune Ginger Boom, and my Trex Light inspired rage tune Trexy Pad.
That's okay. He might be Trexy Pad, but I got blood red Trexy Pad.
Yeah, yeah. Trex is always bleeding.
Ain't that the truth?
Oh man.
But moving on for this tonight, I want to show this clip real fast. And over on the DC Universe Online YouTube channel, it's actually been getting some attention, so to speak. Because the first episode I want to talk about is The Atom, none other than Brandon Routh.
Formerly known as Superman.
Yeah, him. he sat with Spittle and played DCUO on Xbox One, which I am completely, completely jealous over this.
Oh yeah, dude. I mean, this would have been awesome. I mean, when they released the video out, I was like, oh my god, was this live streamed? When did I miss this?
Exactly. I mean, and right now on screen, as what you see is an Atom-inspired suit that they made with all the other gear that we have in the game. He made an Atom suit. So now the fact that I know this is possible, I need to figure out what styles those were, because I want that outfit. I want that.
Yeah, take a look closer, look at those, see what those styles are.
But yeah, it's like, and here's the thing, is like, I want to make sure I get this right. I hugged Spittle, and I'm sure Spittle hugged Brandon. So does that mean I hugged Brandon?
Trex, right when, we're talking about something cool, you got to get creepy with it.
Would you not want to hug Superman? Would you not? I mean, even if it's the one that we really don't talk about, I mean, would you not want to hug him? I mean, he's Dylan Dog. It's Todd Ingram. He's one of the evil ex-boyfriends. I mean, and of course, he's the Atom too. I mean, first off, after watching all Legends of Tomorrow, Brandon Routh, the Atom, needs a hug. Because he has gone through some stuff, man. He is a bro that needs hugs.
Dude, how about that last, how about the ending of that Legends of Tomorrow from last night, though? Did you watch it last night?
Season finale, last night on Legends of Tomorrow. Not going to spoil it, but it really brought the whole season to a close, and I was really thoroughly enjoyed by it.
Yes, and all I'm going to say is, if any of you out there listen to another podcast I do with a buddy of mine named Neo, it's called the Weekend TV or something. Yeah, we talk about all these superhero shows and everything. If any of you out there have listened to this, you can testify, all right, that Warner Brothers, DC Comics, DC TV, and CW, they owe me my 1%. They owe me my 1%. I want my 1% now. Yeah. I want my 1%.
I mean, Amy, we're shifting gears, of course, while the video is playing, really, because really fast. Supergirl is now a CW television show starting this fall. So the lineup for CW is Monday Supergirl, Tuesday The Flash, Wednesday Arrow, and then Thursday is Legends of Tomorrow. And they don't have a Friday slot. This will be the perfect opportunity to talk to NBC and get that Constantine. Come on. And that would be the perfect hour block for me on a Friday night is, or even actually about 3 hours. Because you can give me Vampire Diaries, give me Constantine, and then give me the originals. I'm completely, that's my Friday night. I'm skip podcasts, I mean, because I'll be done by then.
No,
I mean,
Grimm? No Grimm?
Well, I mean, I watch everything on Hulu, but I mean, I'm just saying, like it just rounds me out all the way. But it was really awesome for Brandon Routh to come on and play some DC Universe Online, and I hope he enjoyed himself.
Yeah, and apparently he's not the only cast member that plays DCUO. The actor who plays Jax, the younger side of Firestorm, mm-hmm. recently created a tune on DCUO, and apparently he called out the actor who plays Rip Hunter. You know, saying, yo, you know, you got to get on this. And he was, you know, when he was like, yeah, I left my PS4s at home.
Look, like, I'm pretty sure. And here's the thing is like the actor who plays Rip Hunter is Arthur Duvall. And I know him better as Rory from Doctor Who. So if I knew that Rory was playing DCUO, I would find that character. No, that would be bad. That would be a bad fan. I would geek out. I wouldn't try to hunt him down and try to like, oh my god, this is so cool. Hey, you're so awesome, Rory. You're the best. You are the Centurion. You are the man, the Roman. There's references. I'm sorry, people don't get that. Big Doctor Who fan. But yeah, it's awesome to see the DC TV collective showing some love for the video game and of course, bringing new players in who are questioning it. So it's really awesome. And, you know, if any time, you know, and still, Supergirl is still welcomed on the show. I don't know who we have to contact somehow, but, you know, you are still welcome.
Well, it's been announced. Well, you're talking about on this show.
Yeah, on this show. We need her on here, yeah.
Yeah, we did invite her a long time ago. But you see, it's been announced. There's definitely a crossover. A huge crossover event between all four shows.
In December, yes.
Coming next year. Next seasons, I should say.
Cannot wait. So.
Tip Runter. Oh my god, Greg.
So, first thing we're going to talk about is the booster bundle has returned. I know Brittany has been waiting patiently for its return too.
Listen, can we wait until Brittany's here before we talk about the booster bundle anymore?
She's in a raid. I'm not sure how long it's going to take her.
I know, but we can talk about the other things that came yesterday.
Okay, we can do that. Well, we can wait. I'll be nice. Even though I'm not really, because people tell me. So, first thing is we have the story so far. Episode 24 released along with Game Update 60 yesterday for all platforms. Which it's one of those things where even Metz came out onto a thread because people were really wanting to know where it was. And he came out and said that they are basically waiting approval. Now, for the players who don't know what that means, is on PC, we don't have to worry about approval. If they're ready to launch it, they will launch it. That's why we have a PC test and not a console test.
They don't care what happens to your PCs.
They do not. I mean, I don't get NVIDIA driver errors.
Every time you PC players are downloading a new update, you could be getting significant amounts of malware and not even know it.
what am I gonna get? Daybreak ads in my game? I already get that in Xbox.
It's like you see that video of Meps and Spittle kicking rocks. Just randomly pop up in the middle of a raid.
Oh my god, I would lose it. I would die. I would laugh so hard I wouldn't even care about the wife. I don't know what I would do. But the approval process is there for console, for PlayStation and Xbox, respectively. So what they have to go is Daybreak has to send the game to PlayStation and Xbox Quality Control, and Quality Control has to test it. They have to look at it to make sure that even client hot fixes are the same or kind of the same way. They have to go through a rigorous test of approvals to make sure that the hot fix might be good for the game. But is it going to be good for the console, and will it affect other games? Will it affect anything else that PSN has to offer? That's what kind of tests they have to go through, along with Xbox Marketplace. So once these Xbox and PlayStation give the approval, that's when the devs can say, all right, we can give a launch date. Let's go ahead and do it. So we don't know when they got their approval, but
my guess would probably be the day they announced the live stream. They've been running late on this one. They know they've been running late on this one, and they wanted to get it out as quickly as possible. So yeah, my guess would be the day they announced the live stream, which was what, Wednesday?
They announced it Wednesday, yeah.
Yeah, so yeah, I'm pretty sure they got the call, and then like 10 minutes later, they were like, let's do a live stream tomorrow, and we'll they did the live stream Wednesday, so they probably got the notice for approval like late Tuesday.
Oh yeah, that's right. That's right.
And right after that, they were like, okay, let's do a live stream on Wednesday, so we can talk about all this. And we we'll throw in the booster bundle too.
we have to say apologies. We have to do apologies. Let's just do this.
Yeah, like Michael Grid says, we'll do it live.
So
I'll write it and then we'll do it live.
So what we have here is a story so far written by our good communications manager, Dex. She's a fantastic community manager. So what we have here, Darkseid's War Factory. A little story time, folks. Hope your eyes are ready. So the journey to meet and hopefully defeat Darkseid began with Episode 11, Halls of Power Part 1. You remember Episode 11, Halls of Power Part 1? Mm-hmm. I remember. Good times. Good times. In this episode, we first learned that Darkseid was sending his agents below the surfaces of New Genesis and Apocalypse, gathering relics in an attempt to harness power of the old gods by recovering ancient Third World artifacts. By Episode 14, Halls of Power Part 2, you remember Episode 14, right? That was good times, too. Yep. That was, the best times.
Except for having his home.
Still haven't been there, so I don't know. But fail exams, still all my favorite instances.
Oh, no. Oh, I hate fucking fail exams, man. Oh,
Pugging, yes, God. That sucks. That's horrible.
Oh, my God. I hate fail exams. Onto the pad. Roll up onto the pad. Roll up onto the pad. Don't roll off. Stay. Stay. Stay.
Why'd you move for? Why? God. All right, so they had uncovered even more artifacts. At the same time, a skirmish broke out on the surface of New Genesis as Darkseid's forces attempted to attack Celestial City. And at her quote-unquote happiness home orphanage, aka a deadly training facility, Granny Goodness was testing the mettle of Earth's heroes and villains in an attempt to recruit and prepare the denizens of Apocalypse to serve Darkseid. Now, for a while it seemed that Earth was safe from Darkseid's meddling, until Episode 23. Well, we all remember Episode 23. Last month. The war between the new gods once again heated up on New Genesis, and players reported to the battle site in order to help defend the area from Darkseid's invasion force. Though the players triumphed over Steppenwolf, he left with an eerie message. The source will speak to Darkseid. So, in Episode 24, Darkseid's War Factory, players of DCO will finally have the opportunity to meet this massive supervillain face-to-face. But who is Darkseid anyway? Well, there's a whole bunch of information there, and of course, we have to give knowledge to Jack Kirby for creating it. Thank you, Jack. Rest in peace, sir. So, in DCO, he has amassed... Oh, go ahead, sir.
Before you continue too far, I just want to ask a quick opinion poll in the chat here while Trice continues on. Quick question for all of you. Which would you prefer to pug? Fatal Exams or Happiness Home? Go. All right, continue, sir.
Oh, oh my God.
Fatal Exams.
Listen to this woman. So, now in DCUO, he has amassed enough world old world artifacts to reshape them into a machine that will allow him access to the source. It will be up to you to head to Apocalypse and confront him and as many of his vicious allies before he's able to unleash that divine power onto Earth. Do you honestly think you can beat Darkseid? You guys have beaten Darkseid, right?
I know Brittany has.
Who? Oh, yeah. I just got done beating him.
Congratulations.
I got beating him.
That's a 164 tank. So, LOL, those people saying that you need to get gear for it. Okay, sorry, go ahead.
So, so this is, I read a little bit through this thread as well. This is the epic finale of Halls of Power. We may get an epilogue like we did with the Trigon story, but this is it. This is the big fight with Darkseid. There's even an elite version, so it's not like he got Necroned by just some random normal 8-player raid. That makes me sad still, but not really. It's still a fun fight. So this is it. This is the finale. And since both of you guys have actually been in the instance, is this the finale that we've been waiting for?
Well, I can't speak to it because, you know, we were having some struggles last night. Figuring out the, getting the mechanics down right on the first boss and everything. We had a hard time of it. But, you know, Brittany, you know, she's beaten it a couple of times at least. So let her yammer about it, I guess.
Well,
blah.
I didn't really like the Halls of Power storyline anyway, so I don't. So yeah, asking me about the story is kind of probably not the best thing because I don't really have a. I don't play the game for the story. I play it for like the combat and that those type of things. I'm not really into this story per se.
Let me ask you this. When you guys beat Darkseid, does it basically seem like, you know, there's not going to be anything?
No, seems like there's going to be something else because he says, like, the title or the headline that you get is something like, this is the end, or is it? So it makes it sound like he's going to come back. Like, there's something else.
Well, like, Darkseid always comes back.
Well, yeah, it doesn't sound like it closed out this. Like, that was it. That was it. It sounds like he could possibly come back for something else.
Okay.
All right. And then next, in episode 24, is Harley's Heist. Even if the world isn't about to end and you're not fighting for the survival of civilization as we know it, there are still classic comic capers happening all around DC Universe. That's what you'll be encountering in the second piece of episode 24, the new duo, Harley's Heist. It's a brand new storyline, so there's not much of a story so far to catch you up on, but we can give you some background into what you're in for. So, basically, Harley Quinn and her fellow gals of Gotham City, Catwoman and Poison Ivy, are planning their inaugural heist at the Regal Hotel. Will they succeed, or will the heroines of Gotham City, Zatanna, Black Canary, and Huntress, foil their plans before they get too far? I feel we could have chosen some better birds of prey here. I mean, is Zatanna really a Birds of Prey?
I don't think she is, to be honest with you. But, I mean, how can they go in there with Black Canary, Huntress, and Oracle?
Yeah, where's Batgirl? Can I give you some Batgirl?
Yeah, I think Batgirl's supposed to be involved later on.
Okay.
In the storyline.
And you know what? This is a SJ thing. It's a Nerd of Prey thing. So, I shouldn't have doubts. I feel that she's going to destroy, like, this whole storyline is going to blow up and awesome. So, you know, just, yeah, it's going to be great. So, there you go. New storyline for Harley's Heist. This begins now. So, the first part of the storyline is now, and then episode 25 will have part 2, and then episode 26 will have the finale of the Harley's Heist. So, for 3 months straight, we're actually going to have one complete story. That's cool. I like it. So episode 24 is out for members and for non-members as well to purchase in the in-game marketplace. So that was pretty cool that the non-members don't have to wait another week, because why would you want to wait anymore? Because, you know, it's like in the middle of the month. So in the end, I mean, you know, things happen. Things happened. So hopefully server quality, lag, and stability is hopefully fixed across the board for all platforms, so you guys can go out there and enjoy episode 24. So how's Harley's Heist for you guys?
It's fun. It's fun. I mean, it's not like, mm-hmm. It's definitely, I mean, when you first go in there, don't go in there thinking you're just going to blow through it. Because, I mean, don't pace yourself. For those of you, for you regular players out there, pace yourself. Because it is easy for you to get yourself a little bit overwhelmed in there. Especially when you're on that first part, you know, you're trying to get that 5 minute feat. It can be.
Yeah, and don't worry.
I'm talking for your average player, Brick. Calm down. Jeez.
What?
And don't worry, folks, because there's a question in chat here about the Xbox One. Xbox One players are in episode 24 content. I have seen a couple of streams from Xbox that they are in the raid. They are doing the duos. So they are there. Not with a lot of skill points, but hey, they're working on it. And sadly, the census isn't real. I haven't found a census that's updated for Xbox, or outside would actually be able to look and see.
Well, we just looked at one. We saw one just the other day, and they weren't like 164 CR, but the highest skill points on there is like 135.
Yeah, which isn't bad. That's actually pretty good for the amount of time that they've had.
It's not bad. I mean, it really isn't, especially when most likely players are really not getting playing all of the content. And now I do expect some skipping just to get out there, also just trying to get the in game as fast as possible.
Well, those players that, you know, we saw, Jack Steele, I think one of them had like 135 skill points, and they were 154 CR, 155 CR.
Yeah, but they're people that are like 160 plus.
Those are players that they're veterans from, you know, like PS3 days. On DCUO, and I guess they decided, after they left DCUO on the PlayStation, they decided to start back up on the Xbox. So they're very familiar with all the instances and everything like that, so they know exactly what they need to do to, you know, get their skill point, grind their skill points out as they are gearing up. So they know how to get all the feats and everything. So
yeah, and Harley Quinn now has a new voice actress, and I haven't gotten to hear her yet because I haven't ran the new duo yet. I'm planning on running it tonight after the show. But have you guys heard the new voice actress? How's she doing?
She's definitely different. She's definitely different. I wouldn't say she's bad, but she's definitely different, and you can tell there's a difference. And I think that's what's probably putting a lot of people off on her.
Yeah, I bet if she was like at launch, that was her voice, I don't know if people would have that big of an issue, but I think going from the other voice to this voice is probably a hard transition.
and I know a lot of us, especially in my ear, we all have the days of Tara Strong voice in Harley.
She's the original voice of Harley. Been doing Harley for freaking ever.
Yeah, so that's going to ring in my ears always. So I'm really interested to see how hearing this voice and see how it goes.
Yeah, I mean, we're talking about like almost 20 years of her doing that voice.
Yes, I've been brainwashed. Just completely brainwashed.
So, all right, well, everything I'm looking up here on Zatanna, I'm not finding any efficient at all with Birds of Prey. But well, you know,
I guess we need a magic person.
DCUO does have its license to write their stories.
That's true.
Within some confines. And I think they're going to hear, and that's actually fine. I'm fine with that.
This is a Birds of Prey trial edition. Yeah. This is Zatanna's audition for Birds of Prey. That's what I'm going to go with.
Sure. So,
all right. So along with... so here we have episode 24 and the game update 60. And these episode posters are phenomenal. I just love these posters that the group is doing at the studio. Because it shows off the new content. You scroll down, and then you get to see the new styles, the Red Hood and the Firestorm, and oh my god, I want that Firestorm chest so bad. God. Man, these are so good. And the Red Hood is the vendor, and the Firestorm is the drops, right?
Yes. Yeah, there's two different Firestorm styles. You know, obviously there's the regular style, the drops, and the regular raid, and then there's the Elite version of that style, which drops from the Elite version of the raid.
Yeah, I'll just be happy with the regular stuff. I would just be happy.
I don't know, man. That flaming head.
Right? I was saying that flaming head piece is so freaking cool.
Is that Elite only?
Yes. Yeah. But that will come out in the alert. No, it'll come in the alert. So.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, yes. Yeah. Oh, that's mine. Done. That's all day, every day. I got that.
So I'm like, what? You'll be able to get it.
Well, it's, you know, these monthly episodes, they're so confusing. Can't wait. I can't wait till we get rid of them. You know, just not rabble. You know, good old forms. But, you know, the Red Hood chest piece is awesome. I would like it more if we didn't have to have the vest so we could see the actual bat symbol more. But that's me nitpicking. I mean, I like the whole thing. But nothing really. We've covered this the server hotfix pertaining to game update 60 before. The big things you really take a look at is the Celestial Advanced Mechanic update. They now have the 3-second grace period. Congratulations, Celestial. Now shut up so we can move on to something else. Love you guys.
Atomic.
No one's ever happy.
Well, then just give everybody the damn grace period, and then we're good. Everybody will be happy.
Except Ice. Take it away from Ice.
No, Ice is... There's something coming with Ice that's gonna, you know, be putting those guys in their place.
Yes.
You don't have to worry about Ice. It's more...
I was talking to one of my league mates about it. I was like, yeah, Ice is about ready to get doo-dooed on. And they're like, why are they nerfing Ice? Why are they nerfing? I was like, dude, you know what? They're not touching that power at all. I was like, but they're still going to doo-doo all over you.
Doo-doo.
Why do they have to constantly keep messing with the powers? I'm like, they're not touching the power, bro.
So, and the next is the vendor 00 update, which is allowing the tier 6 styles, which, again, are from War of the Light Part 1, Halls of Power Part 1, Amazon Fury Part 1, and then, War of the Light Part 2 and Amazon Fury Part 2. So yeah. Those are the styles.
Keep in mind, folks, if you go to these vendors and all that to buy these styles and all that, you have to have surpassed the content already in order to purchase these styles. I have a hard light tuned, and I was like, oh man, I can finally get the Scion of Ion gear. You know, I just want to at least get the chest and the leg style right for him. So you know, I purchased the chest. But, you know, he's just now getting into that content. So I went to the Zero vendor to buy the legs, you know, for only 10 marks. I was like, where's it at? It's not shown on here. Where's it at? And then so I looked at the patch notes. And that's where, you know, it says, you know, you have to surpass the content in order to purchase those style items. So keep that in mind.
Right. And something new that actually I just noticed for research and development. Plans for old Solar Kohler versions were accidentally reintroduced in the loot choice changes.
Yeah. I was seeing, Brittany, you probably saw it too. Did you see like the Solar Kohler maxes going for like 20 million in the broker?
No.
Oh my god.
Really?
Yeah. I saw Soder called a match plan in the broker for $20 million. And I'm like, are you serious? Why?
That's...
You know, and the thing is, somebody who started playing whenever freaking, you know, they decided to just make extremes just be a universal soda, and, you know, somebody sees a max plan, they're like, oh my god, this is better than the extremes, you know? and then buying that plan, or they got it in a drop, and now they're crafting them like crazy, you know?
Wait, really? Wow.
You just imagine, it's like, oh, this... It's not going to do anything different than the extremes do, guys. You're wasting money on the solar enhancers.
So, and also here for the rewards, the weekly reward boxes are now going to grant 6 solar color extremes instead of 1, and the monthly reward award boxes are going to grant 12 solar color extremes.
Crit says he's bringing back Crystal Pepsi.
No, no, please, no. That's horrible. So now that Brittany's here, we can talk about the booster
bundle. No, Jareth, I don't want to let them use the mic because most of them are probably premium and they're going to be complaining because the soda enhancers cost so much.
That's true.
No, I don't want them to use the money.
So the booster bundle has made its return finally, and I know a couple of players maybe... One at least who is super excited because they've been asking for it nonstop for the past couple of weeks. So with the booster bundle, they've changed it up a bit where they've introduced the new cosmic material. So cool to hear. So before we get into the new cosmic material, let's take a look and see what the booster bundle has in store. So as Super Patriot ranted earlier, which was a good rant and needed rant, the booster bundle is worth $10 base or 1,000 marketplace cash if you're on consoles, which is also 1,000 daybreak cash on PC, you know, 10 bucks. Boom. So, what do you get with this $10? Well, here's the list. You get 150 replay badges, which, thank you, I really need to be resupplied. 1 radar enhancer, 1 R&D scanner, 1 pro repair bot, and 2 total recovery kits, which, all of those items there, is a staggering price of 1,000 marketplace cash or 1,000 daybreak cash. That's what you're getting in this bundle, is $10 worth of this. That's it. But and there's also... Yes, exactly. A free... I want to stress free item with this booster box. That's a bonus reward. And it's an aura box. Now, what is inside this aura box? Well, it's actually pretty cool. Because we have 5 new glimmering aura variants, which is yellow, pink, purple, cyan, and green. Cyan is blue, just in case for those people who don't know. And I don't care what they say, it's purple, not pink. We already have a pink.
Pink, dude. Come on, don't even.
Hey, so, Soups, let me ask you this. Is this dress green or blue?
Don't start with that. That was Cookie Cole, I feel your frustration, sir. I got 11 yesterday. The first 5 I opened were Scion Glimmerings. The first 5 in a row, Scion Glimmerings. All of them. By the 4th one, I was twisting to my controller. I mean, I was feeling the frustration. I was definitely feeling the frustration, sir.
So,
I got a little luckier with the later boxes that I opened, but I understand your regrets.
Along with the glimmering auras, we have 2 new variant auras, the new solo auras, blue and purple, which are by far the hot ticket items from this new bonus reward box.
Blue solar aura is so gorgeous.
That thing is going, I think the highest I saw was 50 mil. On the broker, the lowest I saw was like 25.
It's down to 18. It's down to 18 mil. I just saw earlier.
Oh, that's the new lowest. Is 18?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. When the bundles are out, the price is 11. They end up dropping after the first day. People try to like offload them super quick the first day, and then they go down. And then once it's gone, it's then that's when the price starts to go up.
Yeah. And so those are the auras. And now we have a new ultra rare, ultra super chocolatey new item, which is the new cosmic material. Now, if you've been a player forever, you already know about the cosmic skin, which is basically you look like the universe. It's basically Donna Troy's jacket or her vest or whatever the hell she calls it. So what is this cosmic material? Well, in the live stream that they did, the live stream preview that you can, of course, find on the YouTubes, which I actually, of course, have a video for it that I'm going to play later. The materials are a new kind of character customization, a new way to differentiate your character's visual costume design. Materials allow you to overwrite the existing texture on the styles your character is wearing with a different texture, a different material, as it were, to give yourself a multitude of new possible looks. So, they were nice enough to give us some screenshots. So in the style menu, you click your little color button there. You scroll down and you'll see some new arrows above your color slots. That will be where your material is. Now right now we only have cosmic, but they've said that there will be more material coming down the line. And there have been some spectacular suggestions on the forums. So I suggest getting your voice out there. What would you guys like to see? Head over to the forums and find some of those threads. And voice what material you guys would like to see. So, and this is what the cosmic material looks like. They use cosmic material on a pair of gloves. So now the gloves look all cosmic-like. You can do them on any singular piece of gear, or weapon, or hair, including beards. And I think it even works on the barbarian skin, but I could not get a definite yes on that.
I don't think it works on your actual skin. Because there is a cosmic skin that you can purchase from the marketplace.
Yeah, that's true. But I mean, you know, the barbarian has those nice designs, the tribal stuff that makes me look like an idiot. So I would like that having looking with a cosmic look. But understood. So you can do them on individual pieces of your gear, or you can just do a once-over, just to do all of it. Actually, it says it right here. Excluding emblems, auras, and skin itself. Damn. So, boo to that. So, if you guys want to apply the material to all, you'll just go over to the Colors tab, and you'll see Apply Material to All, and you're done. And that's exactly what it looks like in the picture there. So I'm really happy to see that we at least get a taste of what the cosmic material is, this new material stuff. I personally can't wait to see, like, you know, steel or grass or water. I would like to see water. Just, it would make my ice character, who's already wearing the whole aqua suit, pretty awesome. There is no such thing as a T-Rex material. That is so weird, Brittany. What is it, like a face? My face on your gear? Is that what you want? Because no one wants that. I don't even want that. It's like a face cake. Who wants to eat that? That's... Oh, thanks, Brittany. I see that now. The game will crash if that happens. Thanks. You're a peach. You're the best, Britt. You're the best.
I do what I can.
Yeah. So, now, of course, I am with the rest of the community that the cosmic material really should have been on the marketplace by itself.
I can get behind that. I can get behind that. Because this is a new feature. This is a new feature.
It is. Now, of course, this is going to cause the booster bundles to spike. So, you know, on a business standpoint, touche business people. I mean, you want people to buy this. I mean, if the blue in the purple Scylla aura wasn't already a selling point, this new cosmic material, like, holy crap, let me just throw the money out. I'm going to make it rain on Daybreak. And so on a business standpoint, I get it, and I certainly do. But it's also an ultra rare. You really are playing the lottery with this, so you might not get it. And if you do, you're lucky. And congratulations, because you're done. I mean, technically, I'm done, because I opened up my first box and I got the purple Scylla aura, so I'm basically done. So, stab, knife, twist. But the materials really need to be on the marketplace by themselves. I'm pretty sure if you make the cosmic material $10, make it 1,000 marketplace cash, I would be okay with buying that. And me, as a consumer, the max I would spend, 15. 1,500. That would be the max as me as a consumer. Not speaking for everybody else, but me. I would spend $15 on this material. So, what do you guys think about this material?
I mean, it looks cool. I mean, it's not something I would use on any of my characters, to be honest with you. I mean, aside from maybe a weapon or two on a couple of them, you know, I mean, I'd probably use it, but I mean, it's not something that, you know, really grabs me as itself. Just the cosmic material itself. Now, other materials, future materials, may like really pop at me, you know. So I don't know. Like I said, this is something. I don't agree with it really being, you know, the new rare thing for booster bundles.
I don't either. It should have been a marketplace only item, and there should have been maybe two or three on the marketplace, and then an ultra rare one in the booster bundle. It shouldn't have been that just this one was released only in the booster bundle. I don't like that at all, because I don't think that this feature, and especially since this is the only way you can get it, it should have been in the booster bundle. So,
yeah, and so, and because it's now in this booster bundle, what would be the backlash if, say, in 6 months, when the next material is coming out, not saying the next one's coming out in 6 months, I'm just like ballparking this, you know, hypothetical, whenever the next material comes out, what would be the backlash if they put the cosmic material on the marketplace?
I don't think there would be backlash. I think that would be the right thing to do. I mean, that gives everybody the chance to get it. And it's cosmic. It's cosmic. Come on. It's not like this is super rare. It's already like a original skin, you know? Like,
the cosmic skin's the first skin they put out on the marketplace.
Well, yeah, but I mean,
that was years ago. It was years ago when they did it. So you're right. It's not like it's something really new with the cosmic. You know, I mean, they've already sell styled items and packs that are cosmic on the marketplace. Yeah. So
hold on one second. Catmon said in chat here playing around, because everyone's playing around now. New UI only available in the booster bundles. Catmon, you go to hell.
Don't worry.
You did not say those words
before anybody else.
Maybe this booster bundle won't supply a popcorn machine. Maybe it can actually fund the new UI. Ooh, I just spoke bad words. But yeah, you know, I mean, these body condoms, I mean, materials are great. I'm really interested to see what Nick.
I'm telling.
What? You can tell all you want. I don't care. I'm not scared. But I definitely feel that the cosmic material needs to be on the marketplace. It's players are wanting new items on the marketplace, and putting this as the booster bundle, I get it. On a business standpoint, I really do. But to really make it sell for players wanting to buy things on the marketplace, your players want to buy things. The marketplace, sadly, just doesn't have really a place for players to really want to buy things. And of course, I mean, DCO probably has their logistics and they have their stats and they can see that players are buying different things here. But this is one of those items that, like, hey, this would make a killing on the marketplace by itself. Just a killing. Just out the ballpark. Players going to go buck wild over it. But I also see why they put it in the booster bundle as well, because of that exclusivity. That you'll see that one player is like, hey, where did you get that? Oh, I got this in a booster bundle a couple of months ago. I'm cool.
No, but like they could still do that, though. They could do it both ways, which is why I don't understand. They could have put, like, I don't know, glowing and... What is the other one? It's not, like, checkered, but... There's another, like, skin that's really obnoxious, and I can't remember what it's called.
It's that checkered one. Yeah, I know which one you're talking about.
It's not checkered, but, it reminds me of that for whatever reason. But, I mean, they could have put those two on the marketplace and then made the cosmic one the, like, ultra-rare or whatever in the booster bundle. And
it's the prismatic.
Oh, prismatic, okay.
Yeah.
And I think people still purchased it. Like, I don't know. It's just, a feature like this, I don't think should be subjected to a booster bundle. Like, and that being the only way to buy it. Like, I don't like that at all.
It's the plaid. It's the plaid skin.
Plaid
or fractal. I think Aaron might.
Well, either way, like, just, they could have had, like, a couple options on the marketplace, and then, I mean, sold those for freaking $10 or... I don't know however much they wanted to sell them for. I'm sure people would have still bought them. Heck, I probably would have bought them just to have them because I like to have everything. So,
yeah, I mean, I really wanted the purple aura, and the fact that I got it on the first try again, it's like, I'm like, you know what? I'm done. This is really awesome. I'm okay. And of course, I mean, and you know what? I spent my Daybreak cash. My free Daybreak cash I get because as a member, I get $500 a month, and I saved up. So I didn't save up enough, but I saved.
Do you even use your Daybreak cash, though, on anything?
Not really. I actually... What was the last thing I bought before the booster bundle? I think I bought...
The previous booster bundle?
I think I bought an aura and... Yeah, I bought a couple of auras that I wanted for some alts, and it wasn't replays. I bought something. Oh, that's right. I was trying to save up to buy an armory, but I didn't have enough, so I had to wait another month, and all of a sudden the booster bundle came up. So, and you know, I sometimes forget to hit that button that says, hey, get your free stuff. And it's like, God, I hate this so much.
I do too. I don't like that they changed that. I liked having my PC tune just sitting there, and then I would log in, and I would have a bunch of market or station cash or whatever you call it on PC. But dang it. I have to actually go in there once a month and redeem it. This sucks.
Yeah, I hate it. I hate it so much. But, I mean, I did get the green glimmering aura that you see now on screen. This is a video from the live stream on DCUO's YouTube channel at youtube.com/DCUniverseOnlineGame. So I got this green glimmering aura, and I'm like, I don't want this. So, I have a nature tune I'm leveling up, so I might just throw it to him. But now I'm trying to figure out who I'm going to give the purple aura to, because the purple aura is perfect for a mental character, and my mental character is on Xbox. So I'm kind of foobard. But at this point, it's whatever. It's whatever.
Make a mental tune.
I have one. He's on villain.
No leg to stand on there with your bitching right there with that.
Yeah, but my mental character is active on Xbox, but it's okay. I'm giving it to my quantum character, so it's gonna work out for him.
It doesn't look good with quantum cards.
Shit, it doesn't.
No.
Well, I'm not gonna give it to Trex Rage. He's Rage, for God's sakes.
Yeah, you got to give the blue either to an ice, electricity, or a water.
See, if I have blue, it would go straight to water.
Yeah.
Dang it. I guess I'll have to give this purple aura to my villain mental character then. He'll be fine. Guess that means I have to play villain more. Poop.
Can you just switch one of your heroes to mental?
That mental character that was hero, he switched to quantum when quantum came out. What? Yeah.
Oh, you don't have the blue one, though. Never mind.
Yeah. If I had the blue one, I would be, like, I would save that for water. And speaking of blue aura, here's the blue aura and its fashion on screen now. And I think it was Chillcat who's in chat. He got the blue aura and created this awesome Zoom character from the Flash TV show. With that aura works so well. With that whole Flash look. Like, we need that helmet, by the way, Nerd of Prey. We need a Zoom helmet. We needs it now. I guess, I mean, Chill, I know you, I think you posted it on Twitter or took a picture of someone with it. I don't know.
Yeah, was, you put a picture up on Twitter just from last night, Chill.
Okay. And here's a purple solar aura.
Jaxio, stop it. Jaxio with his water is only in booster bundles.
Well, I mean, Microgrid's over here with gender respect tokens available in Target. Oh my god, Grid! No! Bad Grid! That's horrible! But anyways, the purple soul aura, it's awesome. It's not, okay, it might be a little pink now I look at it again. Shit.
Thank you. I mean, even SJ said that DCUO's purple is pink. So, I'm sorry. Vindication right there from me. Vindication right there. I've been saying it all the time. Even the OG purple aura is pink.
Well, there's purple in the outline. Like, around the pink, there's purple.
If you squint hard enough, it looks purple. Yeah, but the
pink
isn't actually
pink, though. It's, like, opposite. It's, like, their version of pink is purple, and their version of purple is pink. Like, it's weird.
I am really going to need the colorist at that studio to get their shit together.
But it's like with the pinks and purples, though, which is really odd, because everything else is fine. But... it, for whatever reason, pink and purple just aren't on the same page as what I would consider pink and purple.
Bizarro pink.
Yeah, exactly. Bizarro pink.
But it is a pretty bitchin' aura, even if it is pinkle. I think someone came up with that earlier. But I have it, what was it? Someone said, Cap said it's going on Celestial Tune. I have a Celestial here, healer, so I might throw it to him or something. But the booster bundle ends on June 9th, so you have about a good 3 to 4 weeks of getting, of purchasing the booster bundle, which is good because I think hopefully next week I'll be able to actually buy a couple more boxes with my gaming money. So I'll be happy with that. It's going to be great. So I really want that cosmic material. Really want that. And or I'll just wait patiently for it to lower the F on the broker to a spot where I can actually buy it. Because at the moment, I cannot.
That blue R is probably not even low enough for you to buy it. How much money you got?
Like 1.9?
Yeah, that's not happening, Trax.
I understand this. I mean, that's why I freaked out when you saw a blue aura for like 1.5. I'm like, oh, I can afford that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Oh, I missed that by like just a freaking hair. I had to miss it by just a hair. Brittany, I was on the broker yesterday. I looked at the blue stores, how much they were going for. I had price ascending. Right? The cheapest one was 1.5 mil. I was like, buy! Buy! Warp. And it came up saying it was in transit or something like that. So either somebody had already bought it or the guy who put it in it was like, oh crap, that's way too little.
Oh my god, how funny would it have been if he posted it, wasn't able to stop himself before it sold. Mm. Like he lost out. He would have lost
too
out.
Bad for him.
Oh, it sucks so much. And Warped, if you have four cosmic materials and you want me to sell my soul for one of them, I can sell you a piece of it. A lot of it's already to different sellers, like, you know, real estate people. It's I'm a timeshare, basically. My soul is just, it's sometimes here. So I can sell you a piece for a cosmic material of my soul. We can make that a writing if need be. We can do it.
You can't sell it to Brittany because, according to South Park, Asians have no souls.
Oh, shit.
According to South Park, man. I'm just, I don't believe that. That's just what they say on South Park.
Welcome to Shitty One.
Remember that episode with the golden PSP with Kenny?
Oh my god, that was so good.
When he died and he was on life support. Hey, Aaron, I don't believe that. I was just, you know, echoing what they said on South Park. I do apologize if I offended you by me repeating it. I do sincerely apologize.
Don't worry, I do not have Horcruxes. I am not Voldemort. It's okay. I have a nose, and I am not as good of an actor as Ralph Fiennes. I will admit that. So, while the rest of this video is going on, because it probably has only a few more minutes or whatever, I want to talk about episode 24. You guys have been in...
I'm surprised I got no reaction from Brittany when I said that, though.
She's a quiet anger. That's quiet rage. That's what that is.
What? No. Super Patriot doesn't get my quiet rage. Who knows that?
No, I get her loud rage. That's how I know she still likes me, though. I get her quiet rage. That's why I know I really pissed her off.
Oh, okay. So, with episode 24, with Darkseid War Factory, I want you guys to give some tips to players out there to what they can expect in the boss fights.
Yeah, help us out, Britt. What do we do?
Well, I mean, a lot of it is, like, you can't go in there thinking that you can just stand in one spot and just DPS your heart out or whatever. I mean, that's not the raid that you can do that in. You actually have to pay attention. You need to watch all the bosses' attacks. I mean, not only the bosses, but there's a lot of things going on in the room, just overall. Right. So, you just have to, I don't know, you just need good communication with your group, as well as paying attention and being aware of your surroundings, because there's a lot of like AoEs that pop up on the ground. There's ads that come out, and you have to watch the bosses as well. And so there's a lot of stuff going on, but it's definitely not something where you can just kind of zone out. But it's kind of, I don't know. It's funny to me that people seem to think that you have to be some top tier player to beat that raid. And you don't. I mean, you just need good coordination, good teamwork, and you can beat it. Like, your whole group doesn't have to be 168 to beat that raid. It doesn't need to happen. Because I'm not 168, and I beat it as a 164 tank, so you don't have to. You don't have to be it in, like. You don't have to run that raid to get the gear to beat the raid. Like, that's not what it is. You can get vendor gear, or you can get duo gear and beat it. So, just comes down to being able to pay attention and work well with your group. Even if it is a bug. Oh, I'm for sure not doing that. I've seen some streams of some pug runs, and oh, no thank you.
So now, the first and second boss, is that just a random rotation of bosses? Because I think you guys have fought different first and second bosses?
Well, when I went in, I went in with the pug group, like as soon as the game came up, I got yanked into a pug group by a couple of league mates. And we went in there and we had Stompa and Calibac, which to my understanding is the worst combination you possibly get on the first boss.
And really? Stompa and Calibac?
Well, Stompa and Harriet.
Oh.
If you know how to tank Stompa, I'm sure it's probably a lot easier, but the tanks that we had in there, because if you get Stompa's back to the wall, she's pretty much not going to go anywhere. As long as everybody, kind of stays away from her, she's pretty much going to be stuck there, and then everybody can just burn down Calibac. And then turn and burn down Stompa. But the tanks that we had, they weren't doing that with Stompa, at least. And I ended up dropping out of that because I wanted to run the duo and try and get plans and stuff like that. An FE8, because I had already purchased the back in the chest from the vendor. And I wanted to mod my gear. but so you know, so then we went in last night, league run, and we had Calabac and Mantis. Now Mantis is a bit of a douchebag because he likes to throw out. Now he likes to do. Now he's the one that likes to throw out those AOEs, those pancakes. In that fight,
more pancakes.
Yeah, more pancakes, and those things stay up forever. The drone comes out, everybody, the drone comes out. I highly suggest you guys kill that drone as quickly as possible. I don't know how you guys were dealing with that drone, Brittany, but that's my suggestion.
Sorry, I missed all of that. Somebody's at my door.
All right, well, why don't you just tell us what you do on the first boss, Brittany?
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, you know, I mean, like, okay, the drone comes out. What do you suggest?
We ignore it.
You ignore the drone?
Yeah, we don't focus fire any of the drones.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, it just wrecked your entire world, didn't it, Soups?
I'm being 100% serious. We don't take out any of the drones. Like, we don't focus fire them. If they get, DPS down because of AoE, then that happens, but we don't focus fire them.
But don't the drones, like, you know, suck, you know, whoever they target, you know, suck the power out of them and put a dot on them and stuff?
Yeah.
Confusing the shit out of me right now. All right. Continue, please.
What?
No, keep going.
Oh, the first boss?
First boss, second boss, you know, give us, you know, some tips.
Oh, depending on who is, well, I didn't know that I...
she had to go answer the door!
Jeez! For the first boss, it kind of depends on who you have. It may be easier to just keep them separated, and they're going to spawn at both the entrance and the exit. I don't know if it's, like, north, south, east, west, or whatever, but adds spawn on both of those sides. So you could essentially just keep the bosses there. And then both tanks should be able to pull their own adds. And then you just focus fire whichever boss you think is the most threatening, I guess, out of the two. If you had, like, Calabac and Steppenwolf or something, I would think you could just solo tank that because that's not too bad. But it depends on your group, like, what you want to do. But I would say the easiest way to do it would be to have one tank at the entrance and one tank at the exit, and just tank the boss, like, their own boss there with ads.
Okay.
But you would need to watch out on the first room. Those, like, AoE pools spawn. They're kind of similar to how, like Blackest Night.
Right.
Those pools, so AoE pools. Basically what happens is somebody will get panicked. Like, there will be a little animation on them. If you break out of that, that's what spawns the pools. So, if it happens to you, you want to get out of that very quickly. But I think that and the ads would be kind of like the biggest thing that you would want to watch out for. Because the Grenadiers are very annoying. Very, very, very annoying. Second boss? Ads don't spawn on Reg, at least. I think they spawn on Elite. I'm not 100% sure. We haven't run Elite yet, but for that one, it's really just watching out for the fire that spawns. And then there's another set of drones that spawn in there that are different than the restrictor drones, and those will blow up on their own. Forget what they're called. I think it starts with a D, but I'm not 100% sure. But those explode on their own, so you would want to watch out for those drones as well, and then watch out for the fire, because that follows you around, which is kind of annoying. Last boss is really, you want to, you can't, well, okay. So with Darkseid, he puts up a shield once he's been damaged and Granny comes out along with ads. So the way we do it is,
oh my God,
we separate Darkseid and Granny and the ads. So you have one tank on the ads and then one tank tanking Darkseid and Granny. You DPS Granny. So when she disappears, Darkseid shield comes down, and we just take out the ads, and then DPS Darkseid, and then you basically just rinse and repeat that whole thing. But the thing with that is, once Darkseid gets to 50% health, he starts to spawn like these lava, like these exploding lava pools. So you have to watch out for that on the ground. And he has his Omega Beam, which can one-shot you, and there's no way that you can survive that. Like, putting a shield on you, putting a super on you, that's not going to help you. You're going to die regardless. But the great thing about the Omega Beam is that it can be passed to somebody else. So if you get it, and like you're the tank, obviously that's probably not a good idea to have it, because you're just going to die. You can pass it to somebody else, which is pretty cool. And that can only be passed twice, I believe. So you pass it to, let's say, the...
How do you pass it?
You just stand next to the person. There's like a arrow like on top of your head. So, I mean, it's very visible if you have it. So you have it, and then you just go stand next to somebody, and it'll pass on to them. And then they should be able to pass it one more time to somebody else. But Granny also does her, those balls that she shoots at people. So you have to watch out for that as well in the room.
So, the shield that Darkseid puts up, is that a reflect shield or...
No, it's just that you can't damage him. Like, okay. Yeah, you can't damage him. And you also can't counter him, which is pretty lame, but...
Are we talking about a Halls of Power boss fight without a reflect mechanic?
Well, what? There's La Sheena. You can get one of the first two. Rooms,
there's
that. So you haven't really gotten away from the whole...
There's no way to line of sight the Omega Beams?
No, there's nowhere you can line. It's a big circular room, so there's
no pillars.
There's nothing. But like in the middle of the room, there's some like beam, and even if you stand in that beam, like it puts like it damages you in there, so you can't even stand there if you want to die. So
all right, so if you're the tank and you get the Omega Beam on, you definitely want to pass it to somebody.
Yeah, usually I say, you know, I have the Omega Beam and somebody will take it. And
I know exactly like, who's going to be getting it from me.
And there's a, like, you can actually pass it to Superman. I still don't understand if that's intended or not. Like, it seems kind of cheesy that you can pass it to him, but I guess
that seems like a legit freaking tactic to me. He's the only one that can survive it.
Listen to this guy.
Well, he can't. He dies too, but then he just gets right back up. So it's...
Well, then there you go. See, I mean, he gets right back up, so he survives it.
First hot fix. Have to go rally him. Superman can no longer take the Omega.
Well, no, you can rally him, but it's kind of dumb to waste your time to rally him because he just gets back up. Like, you don't have to... It's like it's thrown. It's like Wonder Woman goes down. She'll get right back up.
Exactly my point. Pass it to Superman. Sounds like a legit tactic to me.
Be the first hot fix.
It's kind of lame, but... Oh, well. But, yeah. I mean, I don't know. That's... It just comes down to your group, really. Like, I don't...
I mean, Select View is just a group of a well-oiled machine. Each part...
But yeah, we've done it with people, though, that aren't in League. Like, we've done it with our friends, too. So it's not just us. And there are other people that have beaten the raid that... I mean... I don't know. It's not just like you have to be a top-tier player that people keep saying to beat the raid. You don't. I mean, that raid can be beaten by... all types of players. The one thing they have to have in common is that they need to communicate and pay attention. That's just
We don't know what this communicates.
Attention? What is that?
No. All gamers have ADD. I mean, we squirrel.
That is accurate.
No, I haven't gotten to play it yet. That's one of my objectives to get done this weekend through my entire weekend of gaming is to actually try out Darkseid's War Factory.
Oh, trash.
What?
Oh my gosh, he's going to go... You know those one ads that have the shield on them?
Oh, shit.
He's going to go in there and try to pull them and get one shot in. Oh, poor trash.
Well, if this whole communication thing works...
Well, I mean, those things bring me down to about 20% health when I pull them, so yeah.
Now I don't even want to play.
Thank God for Severe, but yeah. And pro tip on those guys, if you want to take a shield down, CC them. Like, that's why you have a troller or a really good tank. It's like somebody, can you just, like, CC them, please?
I'm just gonna replay the duo. That's all I'll do. Spin my replay badges carefully. Just do the duo. Yeah.
So when are you guys trying Elite?
I want to try tonight, hopefully. But yeah. We'll see. Hopefully we have enough people want to try it. Even though I really haven't gotten any gear, but it's okay.
Question here from Operation Hawks. Not on the subject, but just a question we have to answer.
No.
if I have two armories and one with the healer gear and powers, then I change powers and put my other gear in another armory, would I be able to switch between powers? No, you would not. That it does not work that way. If your armory one is fire and the armory two is quantum, your armory one, if you're already fired, then congratulations, you're fired, you can use that gear. In order to use armory two for quantum, you have to go and buy a power respec token, go back to quantum, and then you'll be able to use that gear and stuff and power. You cannot use an armory to switch back and forth between powers. And yes, DCO is still alive. It's even on Xbox now. It's more alive than ever.
Yeah, good. Yeah, us, Gargamon, you nailed down my feelings right there on that question.
Biggest thing though is people are in a DC stream and not this one, but like if you were actually playing the game, they come to that stream, see that there are other people playing the game, and say, "Oh, this game isn't dead."
Yeah.
Especially if you're in like the Hall of in the Hall of Doom or Watchtower, and you see all these other players in your phase, it's like, oh. This game is still
like you see people play.
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, DCO is a liver. What the heck? Yeah.
DCO population is going to be a rare drop in booster bundles. Assholes.
Oh, yes. I'm seeing some players really having some fun time on the Xbox. It's... Again, just going through the whole process again on Xbox when the rest of your community and population are in the same boat as you, it feels really good replaying stuff and relearning it. It's really a thrill. Really have a lot of fun with it. So, and one thing I really have to shout out to, if you are an Xbox player and you do stream, I highly recommend putting the hashtag DCUO on XB1. Or at least say that you're an Xbox streamer, because you know you're being flooded by other PlayStation players and you know like three PC players, including myself. So you differentiate yourself, because Xbox players don't want to watch a PlayStation stream. Xbox players want to watch an Xbox stream. So advertise yourself properly. Put DCO on Xbox up there. That's why I always put DCO USPC or PlayStation. No, USPC or Xbox in my title. Never PlayStation. So, yeah. So, as a recap, episode 24 and Game Update 60 are out now. You can find episode 24 on the Marketplace if you are a non-member. If you're a member, congratulations. You already have it. Get to the CR and go forth and beat that dark dude. That dark gentleman. And also, the booster bundle is here for a limited time. It leaves on June 9th. So you guys have a few weeks to go out there and try and get some cool solo auras, some non-cool glimmering auras, and the amazing cosmic material. And that's really it. So we're going to go into our shameless plug now. Yay. Shameless plug. So if you guys follow us on social media, on Facebook and the Twitter at DCUO Sourcecast, you can just type it in and you can find us there. You can find all the VODs over at youtube.com/trickslight in the Sourcecast playlist. They will link over to Super Patriot's channel as well, because he has a couple of videos. If you guys are looking for the audio for this podcast, go over to trickslight.com. On the Sourcecast webpage, or just type in on iTunes, DCUO Sourcecast. If you guys have a question or a suggestion you guys want us to talk about on the show, email us at dcuosourcecast@gmail.com. Soups, where can we find you?
You can, of course, find me at youtube.com/thedaysells. I'm also on facebook.com/thedaysells, at the Twitter on the Twitter at thedaysells. Man, I haven't screwed up in a long time. And you can occasionally find me here streaming on twitch.tv/thedaysells. Brittany, where can we find you?
Jeez. You can find me on... What? You're like, where can we find you?
Yes, where can we find a you?
Like that. That is nearly, you make it sound like I'm asking for your address, and that is not even close to true.
But while we're on the subject, though.
All right, I think you already know her address.
Huh.
Trex, I think right? You already know what her address is.
I'm pretty sure Trex is outside my door.
Yeah, well, no. That's
no. I'm running a show.
The only reason why Trex knows Brittany's address is because he's not allowed within 500 yards of her. All right.
The judge didn't give me an exact address. He gave me a circumference, a circled area where I cannot travel to. So it's somewhere in that area, I know.
Gosh, Trex. You can find me on YouTube at youtube.com/Brittany, on Twitter at pinkranger_206, or on Twitch at Brittany_Trex. Where can we find you?
You can find me over at facebook.com/TrexLight, over my YouTube channel, youtube.com/TrexLight. And you can find me always on the Twitter at ThisIsTrex. And of course, hit the follow button over on my Twitch channel at twitch.tv/TrexLight. And yes, Grid, we already talked about booster bundles. Where were you, sir? Where were you?
No, I don't think we had the in-depth conversation that, you know, we were going to have with Brittany about them, like the reactions, you know, last night. I got so many messages from people, not just you, several other people were like, "Well, what the hell happened to him? What is going on with the way, you know, the one guy was acting?" And then, of course, you know, I got, you know, tag teamed by four more late last night. I just want to point something out. It really amazes me. I tweeted about this last night too. It amazes me how many business owners and highly educated people play this game that can sit up at 1-2 o'clock in the morning trolling people on Twitter.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Don't you have your highly successful business to run tomorrow morning?
Yeah. That Fortune 500 company is not going to run itself.
don't you have, you know, a successful job that you have to be to tomorrow morning?
Well, the funny thing is about being highly educated, yet their arguments and like rebuttals are that of like a 12-year-old.
Yeah, one of them described himself to me as a business owner and entrepreneur.
Oh, he has no job.
His words.
Oh, he has no job.
His words. He called himself a business owner and an entrepreneur.
And I don't know what kind of business he's running, but I can't imagine he'd have a lot of customers.
And he's up at 1:30 in the morning trolling somebody on Twitter.
Is this the person that makes multiple accounts to try to troll people?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's also the same gentleman when the stream ended. The live stream in on DCO's channel, because I stayed there just to answer a few more questions that people had who missed it and whatever. And he came in and berated me, saying that I'm the reason why the game is bad because I don't criticize it as well as I should. I don't criticize it and tell the truth about it. I'm pretty sure that I just criticized it tonight talking about the Cosmic Aura or the cosmic material needing to be on the marketplace. You see,
but nobody watches the Sourcecast. Come on,
that's true. The five people who are here, they do.
Nobody watches.
Literally, when we talked about this the other day, we literally have this conversation about the booster bundles every time they do one. Every time they do one, we have this conversation about the booster bundles. Don't buy them for the auras. Buy them for the chance of getting an aura. Yeah, but don't buy it just for the aura. You know, buy it for the stuff that's in the bundle. And all that, and hopefully, yeah, you do get what you want out of that rare drop, out of that free rare item that they're giving with it. right? You may not, you may not, right? If somebody is uncontrollably unable to, you know, not buy, you know, not stop buying the booster bundles, you know, until they get that, until they get that rare freaking drop, you know, and they end up spending hundreds of dollars on it, that's on them, dude. That's their fucking addiction.
I know.
That's their problem. They are the ones that need to seek help. You don't force a game company or try to, you know, force a game company to change their sales product to accommodate for people who have an illness.
Mm-hmm, I mean, that's right.
This one joke of a guy, all right, put out a YouTube video about me exposed again. I'm exposed, everybody. I've been exposed so much, I should just not wear clothes.
Oh no.
Yeah, get that image out of your eyes.
Oh, give me fire.
Take that, assholes. But, I mean, you know, this joke of a guy, you know, actually, you know, trying to call me out and call out, you know, the devs and Daybreak, saying, you know, so, you know, they are playing on people's addictions to gambling with the booster bundles.
What?
Yes! This is how far morons are willing to go. Idiots, uneducated retards are willing to go to try to find something just to bitch about it.
Did they make that same video? Chuck, didn't you see that Star Wars has something like that? Like, was it Star Wars? Or
It's Old Republic, yeah.
Republic has something similar to what DC does.
All games do this shit. All games do this shit. Ventus SGN uploaded a video a couple weeks ago of him getting all these loot crates and all that, spending all this, you know, in-game currency. It's in-game currency that he earned, right? I believe. I'm not sure how Black Ops 3 works, but it's all this, you know, currency and everything, you know, to get all these loot crates going. And he was wanting a specific item out of it. He was wanting like one or two specific items out of it. All right. He's opened up all these rare drop loot crates. He doesn't get a single thing he wants out of any of them. Rage quit the game and freaking uninstalled it while he was streaming. Shit you not. I don't know how he was able to do it, because normally the stream shuts down when you close off game, you know, when you stream for the PS4. But, I mean, you could see it was trying to stream, but trying to, you know.
game not here. I don't know what to do.
Deleted his game off the console while he was in midstream. And, I mean, and nothing against Ventus. I mean, like I said, I understand everybody's frustration when you don't get what you want from these boxes. I do. I bought many a Booster Bundle box the very first time they came out and got many a purple fucking aura.
These guys don't know what the struggle was back in the day.
They don't know.
Hoping to get an OG Plasmic. And when it got to the point where I realized my chances of getting an OG Plasmic was very slim, and I was spending money just to try and get that aura, that's when I stopped. All right? It's a matter of self-control. If somebody has a gambling problem, they need to seek medical help, psychological help, not appeal to the developers to change their freaking sales practice.
But that's like the people saying that DC was promoting drug use by introducing serums as a power. Like, yeah. You should not be playing video games. Like, oh my god.
That was certainly a stretch, and by the way, that really pissed me off because I really wanted that power.
I was interested too in seeing how that would work. Like it sounded neat, and I wanted to see it
I wasn't for serums, not because of the, you know, the drug implications, but I wasn't for serums because that wasn't the way I wanted to see a purely super strength, you know, tank power introduced into the game. There's a couple of different ways I would prefer to see a super strength, you know, endurance or a durable tank power introduced than with, you know, serums. But yeah, this stuff with the booster bundles. I mean, you know, one guy just, you know, flipped his nut. You know, says he lost his temper and everything. Apologized for me. There's just some things that can't be unsaid, though. and
all over the booster bus. I don't get that.
Yeah, all over the booster bus. You know, and the fact is, there's like, you know, this one particular individual and all that. You know, that I consider, you know, I consider to be a friend, or at least, you know, somebody that I got along with very well. You know, most of the stuff, other stuff that he's had complaints about, I have agreed with him on 100%. Electricity DPS needs love. Abso-freaking-lutely. I 100% agree with you on that. Yeah, electricity needs attention. PvP is broken still. Absolutely 100% agree with you. PvP needs to be worked on. You know, I mean, there's so many other things that I agree with that I don't agree with the way the game is currently handling it. And I've voiced this numerous times, not just on this podcast, which apparently nobody listens to, because I've voiced it many times on this podcast, but, you know, in my own Twitter, you know, on my own YouTube channel and all that, on other podcasts, I mean, I stepped into the lion's den of a podcast with people who hated my guts at the time. Hated my guts at the time, and talked to them, you know, and told them that I, you know, and, you know, we, by the end of it, we all pretty much seemed to be seeing things on the same page, or at least agreed that, you know, we all, you know, had concerns about the same issues, you know, and all of a sudden, you know, I don't see the booster bundles as a hustle, and now all of a sudden I'm a corporate sellout, you know, and I'm always defending the devs. Are you serious? Are you serious? People need to learn how to control their freaking anger. Act like the adults that they are and grow the fuck up.
Well, I don't think that people understand that their anger is directed at the wrong person. Like,
yes, their moms.
Well, obviously they weren't hugging up as a kid, but I mean, if they really believe that we have this much power over the game, do you not think that everybody would be shooting freaking pink sparkles out of their hands if I controlled this game? Like, come on. Jeez Louise. It doesn't make any sense, but I don't get it. Like, people want marketplace items that sell and that keep the game going. These are part of that strategy. Like, you don't have to buy them. And if you don't want to buy them with real money, you can buy them with in-game cash. There's an alternate way to buy it. Like, you don't have to spend any money at all to get those booster bundles. Yeah. Especially if you don't want anything in there except for the aura.
Yeah, and that's the thing. One of the guys jawing at me last night, buying one, I'll buy the aura out of the broker. Then why are you complaining? what are you? You're just bitching the bitch then. You know, I mean, boggles my mind. Several people got the block hands last night on Twitter for my account last night, because I'm just done dealing with. You know, there's only so much room in my life for stupid, and those guys aren't going to fit in at all. And to the one individual who questioned why he got blocked after saying only one line, who you associate with makes you just as guilty as them.
Well, that's like some guy who said to me in a stream, he's like, I just want to ask you a question that everybody wants to know. Are you dating Meps? And I'm like, really? I'm like, that's what you're going to ask me? And then I like go off on him, and I'm like, basically,
Meps is married.
That's what I said. I'm like, well, if he's married, I think that would be kind of difficult. But you can go, you know, enter your own, whatever you want to enter in there, what I said. But he's like, God, I'm leaving the stream. You're mean. I'm like, really? You type an ignorant state or a question, and then I basically say exactly what you say back to me, and you're the one that's upset? Okay, guy. That wasn't a joke, first of all, but it's nice that you, like, positioned it so that you could say it was a joke if I didn't take to it nicely, but okay. You're the offended one. Got it. Duly noted.
So you and Meps, huh? Do I need to have a... Don't you have a talk with them?
Apparently, because we've been dating for quite some time.
Understood. We're going to take a look at some flights for Austin. Excuse me.
Please. Can't reason with stupid.
Yeah.
What you guys do with your money for the booster bundles, it's your money. But at the same time, understand the risk. The game. Yeah. Also, yeah, hey, thanks, man, for supporting
me. I appreciate it. I appreciate you 100%.
I had $10, which technically I'm not supposed to spend, but I'm like, you know what? I'm going to spend it. But I had 1,000 Daybreak cash on my character. I'm like, ooh, free box. Don't have to spend money. But you know what? I still support the game. I got this $10 sitting here. Let me at least buy this box. Not happy that I got a glimmering aura from it. So, you know, I'm mad because I didn't get anything cool. Freaking green glimmering aura. But I still support the game. It still has my $10 on top of my $15 that I give him.
This guy buys two boxes and one of them is a freaking solar.
Yeah, and that's what kills me. It was like, the free box.
I'm going to complain.
See,
something else.
And here's my thing. I was, you know, I'll admit, all right, I'm straight up fessing up. All right, I bought 11 boxes yesterday. I had a PSN card I bought a while back because I'm like, I'm going to save this for the next booster bundles. Right, and then I threw in some money of my own that I had right now. You know, I bought 11 boxes. First five I opened up, Scion Glimmering. I was five in a row, Scion Glimmering. I was starting to get mad on the fourth one, right? but then the sixth box I opened up, straight up, I'll confess it, I got a Cosmic Material. Woohoo! All right, and I opened up a couple more, and all that, yellows, one green, and I got a blue solar. All right. So that was, but the main reason why I bought those boxes, all right, wasn't just, you know, it was for the chance of getting a rare aura, don't get me wrong, or the rare material, don't get me wrong. But I needed to replenish my total recovery kits. I needed more freaking replay badges. You know, and, you know, a few more radar enhancers to pass down, you know, my alts and everything that I still actually go out and physically pick up the briefings and investigations for, because, you know, I just, you know, I can look on the internet, but it's so much faster to just fly, you know, do a freaking cross pattern on the map and, you know, find the damn things. you know, I mean, so, I mean, yeah, and I end up using everything in there except for the R&D enhancers, because I don't need to farm like that anymore, and if I do, I have a route that, you know, I can, you know, go farm, you know, for like an hour and come out with like, you know, 15, 16 stacks of bits. But, so, I mean, yeah, I'd like to see different consumables. I'd like to see like the radar enhancers taken out, you know, and more TRKs added instead. Stuff like that, you know. So, I mean, it's not like, you know, I completely agree with everything with the bundles, but, you know, calling them a hustle, no, I'm not gonna side with that, because that's moronic.
So as a final note, we will have no episode next Friday, Brittany.
I've already noted it.
Okay, good.
I wasn't like, okay. Confused on whether or not we were having a show today, so.
I got my weeks mixed up. I ain't gonna lie. I got my weeks mixed up and all that, but at least I wasn't, you know, I completely forgot about it.
The likeness is so uncanny.
Right. Spot on.
Hey, somebody last week said that I do the best Britney impression ever. So,
like I said, it's yeah, spot I on. Did.
So no show.
So
there'll be no show on May 27th. We will be back on June 3rd. So, and hopefully we'll get to hear an update on how you guys are doing with episode 24 with Darkseid's War Factory, not machine. Yep. Grid.
Yep. And I will be doing more Britney impressions.
That he will.
It's for the fans. It's for the fans, Britt. It's for the fans. see, this is how I know Brittany is guaranteed to be on every time we do a show together when, you know, I take this over. Because if she doesn't, I'll pretend she's here. I'll be, Brittany, how do you think this new content is? Oh my god, I love it so much. It's so good.
When did she become a Valley girl?
I don't know.
When does that happen?
I mean, it keeps changing. Every time he does it, it just morphs into something different.
All right. Good night, guys. We'll see you guys in 2 weeks.
Bye. Oh, my God.